This is a prototype bipedal robot, a mechanical creature belonging to the family of humanoids. This prototype will be trained using reinforcement learning, and so the design has been kept simple to avoid unnecessary complications. Inspired by agility robotics, our prototype has a half-body design with two legs. Each body part has weight of its own, and the limbs have limited degrees of freedom. Unlike humans, our bot has backward bending knees, a trait commonly found in nature with cats, goats, and horses. But hold on a second, what looks like backward bending knees is actually an ankle joint. In animals like goats and horses, the real knee is higher up and bends forward just like ours. The backward bending joint lower down is the ankle, and their hooves correspond to the tips of our toes. This anatomy avoids unnecessary obstructions by the ankles and is widely used in robotics. To power such a metallic corpse, what can possibly be done? Well, neural networks. The beauty of a neural network is that given proper inputs and outputs, it will figure out the rest on its own. So let's see, what exactly does our AI need to observe to do parkour? To begin with, the AI needs some sort of vision. Well, in practice, there is something more important. You see, at any given moment, you know precisely where your arms are located. No one needs to tell it to you, you just know it. This is called proprioception, or body awareness. To make our AI self-aware, the rotation, position, and velocity of each limb is fed into the neural network as inputs. This gives the AI basic awareness, a feature humans have built in. For actions or outputs, the AI can control each of its limbs with limited degrees of freedom. To successfully perform parkour, there is one additional input the AI needs. While body awareness helps the AI to balance and run, to jump over these gaps, the AI needs more information. We achieve this by firing 7 ray casts in front of the AI. These sensors will help the AI feel the terrain ahead of it and react accordingly. Reinforcement learning is precisely how human babies develop. Toddlers first learn to walk and then run. We will use this exact framework and break our training into 2 sessions, walking and parkour. For the walking training session, the robot's orientation will be randomized every single episode. A cube will be randomly spawned around the area, which the AI has to face towards to earn rewards. Every episode, a random target velocity will be chosen from a bracket. The closer the AI gets to this target velocity, the higher the reward. This mechanism forces the agent to walk at different speeds and trains a robust neural network. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for our first training session. See you on the other side. Our prototype has successfully learned to walk. While the walking style may not be perfect, it's definitely an improvement compared to other sessions. That's right, this simulation was run multiple times, and every time the bipedal robot adopted a different stride. This is what makes reinforcement learning tricky and hard to understand. It's difficult to say why the neural network behaved the way it did. Fortunately, understanding how AI and neural networks work has never been easier. With brilliant, that is, Memorization is boring, so Brilliant takes a hands-on approach with thousands of interactive lessons in mathematics, science, programming, and AI, all crafted by professionals from MIT, Google, and Microsoft. I personally tried their latest LLM course, which takes you behind the scenes of how large language models like ChatGPT work. You will explore the fascinating process of how these models learn to understand language, make predictions, and generate text, from building up their vocabulary to selecting the next word. Whether you're looking to craft a poem or draft a cover letter, this course will show you how to fine-tune these models to get the exact tone and style you want. It's an engaging, hands-on journey that makes the complex world of AI accessible and exciting. To explore all that Brilliant has to offer, you can try it out free for a full 30 days by visiting brilliant.org/cozmouz or scanning the QR code. There is an extra bonus for Cozmouz viewers. Anyone signing through my link will get 20% off an annual membership once their trial ends. Before we proceed with the parkour training session, it's important to fine-tune our AI's balancing capabilities. We will now bombard the AI with cubic projectiles. These projectiles will be fired from all directions and will force the AI to topple over and learn to balance better. Ladies and gentlemen, let's proceed with the training. You might be wondering, why is the parkour environment only along one axis? This is because our AI sensors are monoaxial. Theoretically, we could populate the agent with numerous sensors and have the AI parkour in all directions. This, however, requires a much larger neural network and months of training time, all of which would turn my GTX 1650 into a bonfire. That's enough talking. It is now time for the finale. Good luck.